Hello everyone, welcome back to a... I didn't mean to step on that again, I'm so sorry, save point. Welcome back to a new episode of Metroid Prime Remastered. Last time we left off, we finally got super bombs. So now, it'll be like that. It looks pretty crazy. Oh god, I only had... Oh, I have a limited amount of them? I thought they would just kind of refill like that. Okay, well, we gotta be careful with that, I suppose. Yeah, it seems like we have a limited... I wonder how they refill. Huh. That's something to think about. Oh, hello. Well, this is gonna be a... Ow. Hi-ya! There we go. I managed to take out all four of them. Nice. Hello? Hey, buddy? Well, let's start scanning. So anyway, I started scanning. Cryotank failure. Bioform life signs are at flatline. That's the thing that's making noise, the little thingy right there. This is just saying the same thing. Uh-huh. Anything? Let's see, what do we got in here? Because it's kind of hard to tell what exactly it was, but we can kind of see it a little bit there. Just a little claw slash mandible thing hanging out right there. Okay, you I can scan. Auto turret disabled. You don't say. Okay, but where does this go? Because I can't help but notice this. Oh, it just goes under the floor. Well, why? Por qué? Why do I want to go under the floor? Oh. Oh. okay, I could have gotten by the turrets another way. Well, that's neat that they have another way. You can go in the morph ball, go back here, and then just turn the turrets off. That's neat. I think there's been a few of those, because I've seen a few of those things that's like auto turret disabled. So you can kind of sneak past to them, which is neat. I always like when games give you multiple options for progress. I think I hear something walking around. Yes, I do. Yes, I do. Hello, you big doofuses. Oh, great. Metroid containment. Am I just gonna let the Metroids out to kill the space pirates? Oh, I gotta. Come on. Fungal invigoration fluid processing levels normal. Studies indicate decreased aggression between elite pirates and irradiated Metroids. Science team believes the infusion of Phazon in these units may be forming a type of symbiosis between them. Further studies are underway. Interesting. Infusion of Phazon into local fungi is proceeding. The program has produced a cheap, viable ration for many of our Phazon-enhanced units on Tallon IV. Mass production program has been authorized. Yeah, we've heard about the fungus before. Suspension of synthetic Metroid rations has been ordered. Synthetic Metroid rations to be replaced by live bioenergy sources. Yeah. And security now accepting volunteers for hunting parties. The target is Bioform Samus Aran, also known as the Hunter. You'd think the space pirates would be smart enough to have their pirates that are using the ice beam to be guarding the Metroids, but apparently not. They just have regular pirates chilling here. Stupid if you ask me, but... Force field disengage. Metroid containment area breach. Look at this doofus. He's like, what? Oh god! Oh hi, oh you found out about it. Yeah, you think they'd put the ice ones in here. But no. They did not. Well, I'm not a doofus, I'm gonna use ice. Bye bye. Hello, Metroid. Oh yeah, I should... Ow, I was gonna scan one of you. I should have scanned one of you. That might be one of the few times I have to actually scan you. Because I've scanned the Hunter Metroids, but I don't think I've scanned just a regular-ass Metroid. Uh-oh. We might not have the opportunity to run into many more of those. Here's hoping I do. Science team reminds all personnel to refrain from antagonizing Metroids. Severe penalties will be enforced for all violations of this order. And look at their little hand thingy. Look at their little pirate hand. All adorable. Yeah, there was only one Metroid that actually made it to me. The others died to the pirates, I guess? Oh, no, there's one. Hey! Little buddy, the baby! Oh no, it's just- okay, yeah, we've examined Tallon Metroids before. Okay. Hello. Synthetic Metroid ration mix processing in progress. Okay. Alright, we're good. What are these? The giant mushrooms? Size increase of 400% indicated in fungal unit. Hey, little friend. Hey, little friend. Bye-bye. Oh god, what was that? Oh, that was a super bomb pickup, wasn't it? Oh shit. Okay, well that's a new pickup I can get. I thought it was just I was walking into it, and then I realized, as my body was entering it, that it was not the same thing. I thought it was yellow health. But no, that must have been a super bomb, it must have been super bomb ammo. So you pick up the ammo. I was wondering if they, refill each time you go to a save or something like that. And that's the only way you get them, but... Huh. How am I going to get across here? Because that's irradiated, right? I imagine I do not want to step into that. So... Huh. I'm not sure... how I would want to go about getting over here. If I could get up there, but the mushrooms aren't... big enough. Is there a way to increase the size of the mushrooms? Report any force field malfunctions to Operations Command immediately. Do not disengage force field without command authorization. Well... sorry. Is there no way to, increase the size of the mushrooms just a wee bit more? To, allow me to get over there? I'm not seeing a way. I mean, maybe we just can't progress any further this way? Or something? Hmm. Cause yeah, if these were just, slightly taller... I would be good. Maybe I need something that protects me from radiation before I can go in there? Cause yeah, I can't make that jump over there. There's a missile expansion there. I don't see grapple points or anything. Okay. I... guess we're going to leave? Metroid Quarantine A? I mean, why would they let me open this up? If I can't... just straight up can't get in there. I mean, there's another door over here. That I could go into. Let's go back towards that door for now. I can head back over here if I find that all. I can't progress this way either. Alright. Back this way. Let's just make our way back through here. And if I have to go past those turrets again, if they respawn, then hi. How are you idiots doing? There you go. You know, why am I even gonna fight you? I don't need to fight you. Let's just get out of here. Bye-bye. I don't need to do this battle. You're cute, though. There we go. We can go in here and refill really quickly. And then we can head over to that place. Wow, 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 wow. Alright, unfortunately the only part that sucks about this is I do have to platform past these idiots. But I'm not gonna take the time to fight them. They're all ice ones, which is just annoying. They might shoot me while I'm trying to do my platforming, but I'm sure it'll be fine. Oh god, I was supposed to jump onto that center platform. No, it won't be fine. I'll look like an idiot. Get up there, thank you. Yeah, we jump onto this, and then over here. There. Hey, getting out of here is awkward. Alright. Out of this place. Okay, we're good, we're good. Now, over here, yeah, in this next room, there's a door I didn't go into, which probably means it's blocked by, Bendezium or whatever. Oh, hi. Okay, great. Okay, well. Eat that, nerd. Okay. So, yeah, we can't do anything while that's up. So, let's switch to the thermal and see about targeting this. Okay, so what happens if we hit that? Is that just the only way I can damage you? Because I assumed before I was actually hitting you. Oh, you have the thing active. Oh, that doesn't have a heat signature. Oh, that's annoying. There we go. You're dead. Yeah, so that's just how you kill them. You only target them by doing that. I thought you could attack them or that, but apparently that's not the case. Okay, well, that one was taken out. That was not too bad. So yeah, you're the one that was in that tank. Ah, that was set up earlier, the one that was damaged. That's a neat little detail. Yeah, that was the one that was damaged earlier. And now you busted out. So maybe it did want me to go this way. Because yeah, this is blocking here. So yeah, this might be what it wants. There's also more Bendezium blocking the like weird rotating tower thing. Huh? Is this just a map? This is just a map. Good, I need to scan this anyway. Map station. Walk into map station holograms to download a map. Yeah, somebody mentioned that that was a scan. Like way earlier, but it took me so long to run into another one. Downloaded the map. Press plus to access the map. Okay, so now we can see everything. Let's zoom out here. So, oh, that's the upper floor, right? Where am I? Oh my god. Where? Okay, there I am. Jeez, I couldn't find myself. I was lost. Okay, yeah, Metroid quarantine leads to a whole thing, but I can't get across Metroid quarantine, which is a problem. It looks like here in the maintenance tunnel, I can go lower. And I haven't activated this one yet, so this must have Bendezium blocking it. Yeah, and then if I do that, I can get down here, which is a whole new area, it looks like. Possibly. Because that's what that is, right? Yeah, I mean, this isn't listed on the legend because it's only at this place, but I think if I get over here, there's probably something that was blocking me before, but now I can access this because I think the fact that this isn't green means I haven't activated it. Oh yeah, this whole place. Yeah, well, I was going to cut to get back over there, but no, we have to deal with this problem, which, yeah, wasn't there... Ventilation is offline, activation panel... Yeah, clear air flowing from the gate. Bendezium gate. There we go. Let's destroy all of these. Okay, it is just releasing more constantly. So, does it just want me to go in here? Okay, yeah, that's totally what it wants me to do. Oh, aha! So now we activate the fans and we'll be good. Ventilation control restored. Plans online and clearing fumes. Later, idiots. Ooh, and that gets me the E-tank. Oh, beautiful. Oh, beautiful, because yeah, I remembered there was an E-tank in here, but I was like, I imagine, am I going to be able to get that right now? But I can. There we go. Energy tank acquired. Cool. Now we just need to get up there. The question is, how do I get up there? I can't jump high enough. I'm just fucking with you. Not going through that again. Not doing it. Alright, cool. I noticed the half pipe this time. Alright, hello. So, we need to get over here. Well, the Space Pirates Are Around music is playing. Oh, hi. Hello. How you doing? How about I just, you missed. Oh, my missiles are low. Oh, well, we're gonna have to take care of that problem, aren't we? I'll just take you out this way. There we go. Where's some more? There are more. I hear you, you idiots. Alright, let's just go ahead and get on this. Where are you at? There you are. I see you. Are you coming up here? There you are. Okay, and then I'll just take a free pot shot at you as well. And then I just need one more charge and you're dead. Oh, hi. Another one right here. Go away. And... oh, hi! I was like, how do these stairs work? It's a bit hard to see when we're in thermal. But no, we got it. We figured it out. We found that answer. Alright, so yeah, down here... really, this... oh, wait, yeah, oh, wait, this door, huh? What was... Is it just a tunnel that has... Benzedium blocking it, or did I just never try this? Okay, no, it does have Benzedium blocking it. Oh, no! I need bombs. I need bombs. I have no super bomb. Power bomb. Damn it. Where can I get some of those? Haha! Scan! That's what I need. New research. Power bomb ammunition. Resupplies power bomb with one round of ammo. Give me. That's what I needed. Now I'm out of here, you stupid idiots. Alright. Now we're back. Now we're back. Boom. There we go. Alright, I was on my way back to the save point to see if the save point gave him back to you, but I realized I'd saved earlier. But I also can just get them as a drop. So I was like, well, let me kill all the enemies on the way through here to see if I get lucky and get one as a drop. Alright, nice. Now we're in here. Hello. Anything? Nothing? Where am I at on the map, actually? Okay, yeah, we're just right here. So we're about to hit this elevator. Oh, hi. Hey, idiot. Whoop. Bang. Bang. There we go. I hear you. This item. Ooh. Hello. Just go ahead and take this thing out. There we go, that's dead. Anything interesting here? No? Just some HP. I'll take it though. Okay, I thought this was gonna be like a actual elevator room. Oh, there is an elevator right there. It's the Phazon Processing Center. Okay. Wait, what? Oh, yeah, that was the... okay. Weird. Okay, I was confused for a second. I was like, wait, we didn't go down an elevator, but this... just... yeah, it's like, okay, so it's not actually an elevator, it's just like, no, this takes you down to a different floor, even though we didn't actually go down a floor? Okay, gotcha. Loud and clear. Understood. So, probably don't want to be falling down there. A lot of radiation down there. I do, of course, hear an upgrade here. Let's see, does it look like I can actually... I can get over there if I go on this, magnet track. Yeah. Up we go. Yeah, and then I can get... whoop, over to this area. So what do you do for me? This gets me up here. Okay, yeah, this is useful. Good. And then what exactly are you? Okay. Oh, that's a mega turret. That's just a moving platform. Let's, whoops, wrong beam. Eh. There we go, that thing's dead. Okay. So, yeah, let's just continue platforming around here. Maybe this gives me some sort of protection against radiation, and then I can go into the Metroid containment. Because that's definitely what I need, I feel, if we can get radiation protection. If that's even a thing. Okay, we're good. And I need to make it over here. Alright. This is a little... This is just a teleporter? Ooh, we need... Grapple for this? Not sure if that's a... jump I can make. No, I can totally make that jump. Never mind. The grapple probably just makes it easier. Okay. What is this? Magmore Cavern South. I mean, sure. Let's go. I don't know what else I'm doing right now. I really do need to add that item to my list, though. I'm gonna have to go back and do that really quickly. Alright. That has been added to my notes. We are good. Open the door, and let's see where we're going. Oh, this is just over here. Okay, this just gets me back out of here. Yeah, unfortunate. This isn't really what I need at the moment. I mean, there were more places in the Phazon mines I could go to. Yeah, this is just this place, though. Okay. Ooh, more ammunition, thank you. I needed that, actually, to clear this. Actually, no, I already had some. Beautiful. Well, there is one thing I can get while I'm over here. There's some Bendezium that guards... where was it? Not the... geothermal core. It's all the way back at the Warrior Shrine, which is... oh god, it's not as far as the Triclops Pit. It's that one really big room. No, it is totally this. It's the monitor station. There's the Warrior Shrine. And there's a little hole right there that gets me access to something. So, let's go see what that's all about. Oh yeah, so there's actually two things here I can get. There's one right here, which allows me to get Ice Spreader. So that's pretty cool. Luckily, I do have two bombs. And then I can go get the one in the Warrior Shrine as well. So, boom. Boom. Hello. What does this do for me? Imagine there's just an upgrade to the ice beam's capability. Ice spreader acquired. This powerful attack uses 10 missiles. Using the ice beam, hold ZR plus A to charge, then press R to fire. Additional data. Alright, let's go see what that additional data is all about. It's in secondary items beam combo. So, super missile. Ice spreader is the ice charge combo. It can freeze targets in a wide area. Ice spreader in a single shot charge combo. Each shot costs 10 missiles. It's limited against aerial targets. Okay, so it just freezes a bunch of enemies. Well, that's nice. Useful. Alright, I believe this is the thing. Yes, Bendezium is unstable here. Kablooey! Now what does this actually do for me? What in the nine hells is that? Power bomb expansion. Increase the number of power bombs I can carry. Well, that's pretty damn useful. I'll be taking that. Well, that's cool. Did it refill them? No, of course not. It did give me one, though. Alright, well, neato. That's another upgrade for me. I can take those two things off my list, which is nice. Okay, so, I could have went back to the Phazon Mines through Magmore, but I was like, there's something on Tallon that, actually requires Bendezium, and luckily, it's also pretty close to the teleporter, to the elevator that would take me back to, the Phazon Mines. It's over here. It's the Life Grove Tunnel. There's some Bendezium over there. So I thought, you know what? Since we're right by the elevator for Tallon. Why don't we just leave this way instead of going all the way back into that place the other way. So if this leads to some progress, cool. If it doesn't, then I can go back into the mines and everything will be fine. All right, here we are, finally. The Life Grove Tunnel. And this is Bendezium that is now destroyed. So what does this give me access to, if anything? It sounds like it's just an upgrade. That probably requires, little this. I mean, that gets me in here, but... Nah, there's something else in here, though. There we go. See, I need to do some more of those. Huh. Almost gets me there. Okay. Aha! Got it. I was like, this has got to just be destroying this, right? Yep. Cool. So another missile expansion for me. Beautiful. Alright. And what the hell is that? X-ray visor. I frankly didn't expect this to actually have anything super useful in it. I'm gonna be very, very honest. I thought it was just gonna be like, I don't know, an E-tank or something. But that's nice. I will take that. Also, this easily takes us back to the Phazon mines and other stuff. Awesome! I'll take an X-ray visor. I will definitely... Oh, well, that was awkward. I couldn't move and Samus was kind of just sliding down that slope. X-ray visor! Use left to activate the visor. Additional data downloaded to inventory screen. Press minus to access the inventory screen. Well, we gotta access the inventory screen. Visor. X-ray visor. We now have all the visors. Can see through certain types of materials. Can reveal invisible items, areas, and enemies. Robotic enemies jam the X-ray visor's frequency. Eliminate them to restore function. Interesting. Interesting. Okay. Can reveal... Hey, you. It can reveal hidden platforms and things? Oh my god, wait, what? Wait, that's an invisible wall? All of these are invisible walls? It said platform, right? I'm not crazy. I think that's a bomb ammo. I needed that. So, I can just walk... Huh. Or do I need to destroy it? Analysis wall shows rampant weakness due to severe water saturation. Large traces of Bendezium collect... Okay, that's why these things are constantly spawning. And they guarantee drop power bombs. Because, yeah, you need one for this particular area. Gotcha. Gotcha. I was wondering why that enemy was just constantly spawning. Well, there we go. Taking care of business. Okay, and then, is there anything else interesting around here? Doesn't appear to be. Just thought I would check really quickly. Alright, well look at that, we got ourselves an X-ray visor. I'd say we got ourselves a major upgrade, so that's probably where we'll be starting to wind the episode down here. I was supposed to jump over here. Hup. No? Hub-a-da-hup. There we go. Should keep my X-ray visor on just to make sure. Wait, what was that? Hello? Oh, it's just that doofus that spawned. I was like, what is that? Is that an invisible enemy? No. No, it was not. Hop. Hop. And hop. There we go. Okay. And to the people that have mentioned before, yeah, I know about Spring Ball, but I'm just not using it for those sections. When I'm going back through areas, I use it, though. Because Spring Ball is very nice to have then, but, Oh, but why are you mad at me, ancestors? Why, though? Well, they wanna show me, hey, look at how cool the X-ray visor is. I did not mean to fall. Okay. Hello, doofus. Eat shit. So now I can see you, thanks to the X-ray visor, at all times. Yeah, you thought. Where's the final one? Where you at, you idiot? I hear you... That's not you. Hello? Did you get stuck somewhere? I think you're stuck somewhere. Jesus. Stupid even in death. Where are you? Kinda hear you now. There you are. Dang. And you're over here? There you are. Bye-bye. See, now why you gotta do that to me, ancestors? Aha! Now that's destroyed. So now I can get back up there, and we can take care of that. Yes. Beautiful. So... Yeah, I go over here, and yeah, see, this time I'm gonna spring ball, because we've done this. I'm good. There we go. Okay, so... Over here. This is where the cutscene activated for me last time. Now, these things aren't, like, I guess they are kind of tied down, but they're, like, tied down in the middle. They don't seem very stable, you know? They don't seem super stable. Alright, over here. I think one of my cats is scratching something. They're not supposed to. Alright. Boom. We're in. And now we can get out of here. Okay, so that was just how we get out of this place. Beautiful. Uh-huh. Need a little bit of height here, please. There we are. Thank you. And we're out. Wonderful. So now, yeah, we're back at the Life Grove Tunnel. I can go to Chozo Ruins, or I can go to Phazon Mines. It said platforms, didn't it? Didn't it say platforms? Because I have a thought in my head. Invisible items, areas, and enemies. No platforms. I was wondering, well, maybe there's an invisible area by the Metroid containment. Maybe there's, like, stuff there? I guess we don't have, what's that area in Dark Souls called? The area after Sin's Fortress that has all the invisible platforms that you have to toss prism stones on to see where you're walking. Crystal Caverns? Crystal Caves? Might be it. It's where you fight Seath. Alright, well, I think we're gonna go ahead and end this episode off here. I'm not near a save point, so I'm probably just gonna, put my, switch in the sleep mode here, so. Hope you've enjoyed, and I'll see you next time for some more.